All right, just as easy as that.
I just got boosted. What's up, guys? It is 4:42 in the morning. I have been sleeping now for about 4 hours. I have a really, really bad headache. I have a temperature of 100.8. I don't know why we do this to ourselves, but pretty sure I am not going to do this again. Going back to try to get some more rest. Later, guys. Good afternoon, everybody. How are you all doing? It is literally exactly just about 24 hours since I got my booster shot. And I got to tell you something, guys. When I got the second shot last time, earlier this year, back in April, that second shot wiped me out for like 2.5 days. I mean, I had a big golf ball on my arm. My body felt like I got hit by a truck. I had a fever, chills, everything. The first shot, I was perfectly fine the whole time. The second shot affected me that way. And I got the booster yesterday. And overnight, I got chills. I got 100.5 fever. I was going from getting chills to hot sweating, chills to hot sweating. My chest, even right now, still feels like it got hit by a freaking train. It's real tight, real sore. My arm is a little bit sore. I still have a headache. That booster shot gave me a really bad headache also. But everything seems like it's leveling out now, which is a good thing because I have a job interview tomorrow afternoon. And that's one reason why I got the shot yesterday, because I knew the following day if I had the same reaction, I was going to be no good at a job interview. So by tomorrow afternoon, basically 22 hours from right now, I should be fine, hopefully. But anyway, guys, it is a nice day. But yeah, I just wanted to share that with you. And I'm also going to tell you this right now. I decided last night and this morning, if they require you to get any more booster shots or whatever, I am not doing it. I am not going to get another booster shot. I'm not going to get any other type of shot for this virus thingy that's going on right now. Just wanted to tell you that. That's the way it is. That's the way it's going to be. I'm not doing this again. Not doing it again. But that's it, guys. Later. My neighbor's out there replacing my fence. About 8 years ago, I replaced that fence. I asked them for help on paying it. They didn't want to do anything. They said they couldn't afford it. Yesterday they come by and they asked me to help them, get this light in, help them to carry the panels into the backyard. So I helped them and they did everything except straight come out and ask me to help them put that fence up today. I'm in the house. I'm in my office. I'm working on the pool pump video right now. But they were out there. They started earlier this morning. They've been going all day. It's just him and his wife. I mean, I feel bad for her. But they are so cheap that they don't want to hire anybody or, you know, have anybody else do it. They'd rather do it themselves and everything. It's completely ridiculous. I mean, it's not easy work, but it's not really hard work. But when you're one person, I think he's a little bit older than I am, a little bit worse shape than I am. But you know, I'm not going out there to help him. You know, I'm sorry. I mean, that might sound rude, but I'm not. I mean, you know, I asked 8 years ago for them to help pay for it. I mean, I was having somebody do it. I had somebody do it, the back and the side. And they said they couldn't do it. You know, they're just real tight on money. These are the ones that have been trying to sell their house. And I think they're getting really close to finally doing it because, hold on here. Because, I think they're really getting close to doing it because, they got a new roof put on and all that kind of stuff. But it's just funny watching him out here trying to do that by himself. But just thought I'd show you that. Later, guys. What is up, everybody? Got the smoker going. It is Wednesday. Hey, John.
my neighbor. Wave to my neighbor. It is Wednesday, July 6th. Is it? 5th. July. Take two. What is up, everybody? Got the smoker going. It is January 5th. I just got a job with Home Depot, being a sales consultant in several different departments. It's taking off here. So I do have a... You can see it, there it is. I got a ribeye steak on the grill. I am celebrating this job. I'm really looking forward to this. I'm really looking forward to this job. Should be really good. Bunch of different departments doing sales, you know, stuff like that. Should be really good. Orientation is tomorrow, Thursday. It's a 6-hour orientation, so that's going to be a little bit different. So anyway, just wanted to let you know what I'm doing. Later. Good afternoon, everybody, from beautiful Central Florida. It is a 74 degree day here today. Partly cloudy, a little bit breezy. It is January 8th. I know you guys up in Chicago, my friends up in Chicago and up in the north, you're in single digits today. You are in single digits, and I really feel for you. I really do. The sun is bright. You know, kind of get in my eyes a little bit, but I do feel for you. But anyway, I wanted to take you here and show you this. I showed you a little while ago that my neighbors were putting up the fence on the side of the house here. Did a pretty good job. They used the original post, or the posts that were there, and they also had an extra one that they gave me so that I could rebuild my gate over there. But they did do a really good job over here. I mean, really nice job. Now, that is actually my fence. But so I replaced that about 8 years ago. I asked them for help. Nobody wanted to help. Them or the ones in the back didn't want to help. So, you know, I wasn't going to do it again. But the reason it got so bad is because the people in the back and them on the side there, they have sprinklers. And they don't have them set right. So whenever their sprinklers go off, they hit the fence, which warps the wood and breaks the wood and destroys the wood. So I'm not going to... You know, if you don't want to take the time to, you know, aim your sprinklers right, I'm not going to be paying for a fence every 5 years. But another thing here I wanted to show you. If you can see that. It's a no soliciting sign. Now, over all the years I've lived here, I have just, which it fell down, that's why I ordered this. But I used to have just a paper one up here. You can kind of see the tape there that I still got to get off there and there. But I'm going to put this just like that. And hopefully this one will last longer. Because the paper one I made, I just had a template that I made. And I just kept about every 4 or 6 months it would fall off because of the humidity and everything here. So I just, I finally went and bought one. It's got some 3N tape on the back. So hopefully that will go on good. I will let you know later. Good afternoon, everybody. It is 81 degrees here today. It is a beautiful sunny day. I know for all you friends of mine and subscribers that are up north, I am sorry. I know it's bitterly, bitterly cold up there, but you know what? I'm down here. Gotta tell you what it is. But anyway, guys, today I'm going to be doing a simple rotation of my tires on my Mazda. I'm going to take the front tire there, move it straight to the back tire straight to the front. Now, that's called a simple rotation because The proper way to do a rotation is to take like the left front tire here and put it to the back on the right side, and then the right front to the back on the left side. However, I am not going to be doing that. I'm going to be doing just a simple rotation because these tires are old. They need to be replaced soon. Crossing them is really not going to make a difference anymore. So let me get you set up here. I'll do a little time lapse for you and show you how I do it. There we go, guys. Pretty simple. We're gonna tighten them up with a lug wrench just to make sure they're tight. Then do the other side and I'm done. That's it, guys. Later. Good afternoon, everybody. I just noticed I have another light out that I have to replace in my kitchen. I will get around to doing that eventually, but I wanted to show you this. It is a gray, I don't know if you could tell from here, gray, gloomy, rainy day. So I decided that I was going to do a crock pot meal from that place that I ordered a bunch of crock pot meals from, that crock in a pot, whatever. And this is my new little crock pot for one. Small little, I think it's a 2-quart. A small little 2-quart crock pot. Big enough for meals for me, you know, for one. So just put that one in. I already tried the, I think I told you, the steak fajita one. That one was okay. This one here is called Grandma's Meatballs. It's got three big, huge meatballs in there with sauce. And then I think what I'm going to do is, as it gets closer to being done, I got some mozzarella cheese. I'm going to throw some mozzarella cheese on top, let it melt, and then maybe throw them in a tortilla or something, because I have no bread. I just realized a little bit ago, but yeah, I will let you know how that turns out later. I put that at about 11, should be done. It's coming on 3 o'clock right now. Should be done probably about another couple hours from what the bag directions said. I got to test the meatballs with my thermometer just to make sure, but I will do that in a little while. But yeah, I thought I'd throw that in, show you my new little crock pot that I got, and that's it, guys. Later. What is up, everybody? How you doing? That was this week's Around the House. Yeah, just did a bunch of stuff. Oh, by the way, those Grandma's Meatballs, those were really, really good. Those were really good. I think I'm going to order those again. Those were really, really good. I ended up putting mozzarella cheese on it at the end, and you know, just wrapped it up, you know, cut the meatballs, I think I cut them in like half, and then spread them out with the sauce and the mozzarella cheese, wrapped them up in a tortilla, make a burrito out of it. Boy, were they good. They really were good. I would recommend that. The company's called What a Crock, I think is what it's called, What a Crock, and they have all prepackaged meals in a bag. And you just take them out of the freezer a couple days before, thaw them out in the fridge, and then you throw them in the crock pot, and, you know, 4, 6, 8 hours later, they're done. I love it. I love it. yeah, that's it. I did get boosted. I am not going to get another one. I'm going to tell you that straight up. I am not going to get another one. I came really, really close to going to the hospital that night because my chest was so tight, and it hurt so bad that I was actually getting scared. I really was, and I am not going to do that again. I don't care what kind of mandates they put out or whatever. I am not going to do that again, just telling you straight up. It was weird, though, because the first shot, I had no issues. Second shot and the booster, man, those knocked me out. And then, let's see, I had the frog climb over my ring doorbell. I was actually at Men's Warehouse when that happened, getting fitted for Brendan and Paula's wedding, and all of a sudden my phone goes off, somebody's at my door, and I wasn't expecting anybody, So I kind of looked at it really quick, and I seen that frog crawling over my doorbell. But I thought that was kind of funny. But yeah, anyway, did that, got the new fence up. I just started making the new gates out of that one piece. I started that yesterday. You'll see that in an upcoming video, probably in a couple weeks, once I get it all done and put up and installed and everything. But yeah, that's it, guys. Started Home Depot, been on the floor, working paint. It's okay. Schedule's all over the board. I really don't like that. The last 2 days I started at 6 o'clock in the morning. Today and tomorrow I start at noon. And then next week there's some days there I start at like 6:37 at night. I mean, it's just all over the board. I don't like that at all. I'm really trying to give it a chance. But we'll see. I mean, I'm not digging that at all. The work is actually okay. I'm learning a lot about paint. There's a lot of people that come in with a lot of questions that I don't know, and then they get mad at me because I don't know, and the other guy's busy helping somebody else, and then they gotta wait and they get all pissed off. But you know, that it is what it is. You can't do that. But people think they're entitled to being taken care of right away, but that's not the case. But anyway, yeah, I mean, it's going okay. I'm not sure how long this is going to last, to be honest with you, but we'll see. I mean, actually, you know, certain weeks and days, I can make a lot more money driving for Uber than I can working at Home Depot. So take that with a grain of salt. And okay, camera just shut off again. I don't know why it does that. Full power. But anyway, that's it, guys. Come back Tuesday, see a taste test challenge. Another one coming up. I just filmed about 4 of them last weekend. And I still got to edit them. They're still sitting here on the camera. But yeah, come back Tuesday for a taste test challenge. Come back next Friday for another around the house. And that's it, guys. Have a good week. Talk to you later.